Hello everybody, this is Bino4657. Welcome back to Let's Play Tales of Vesperia. I'm sorry if that last video went on a little bit too long. We were fighting a boss for a while, so hopefully you guys still don't mind long videos. I know I keep saying that over and over again, but I just really don't like to take up everybody's time all the time. Time all the time, time all the time, time all the time. Is there a quick way to get out of here? Because, I mean, we can't get any of the extra stuff in here, so why did I do that? Oh my god, I might as well just cut this. This is balls. I'll just see you at the top. Okay, I'm actually going to control Estelle again, because, to be honest, she's being really, really stupid. Like, she just keeps using all her arcs all the freaking time. All these big healing spells when we don't even really need them. And I just wish there was a way that I could just get her to stop. And the only way I know how to do that is just to use her. God, I can't believe I keep using this cleric so many times.
Cover me, would you?
I'll protect you.
I like how enthusiastic his spell sounded back there. Like, I'll protect you, yay! I don't know, I guess that's actually one reason why I actually kind of like Estelle, that I actually really like Estelle, is that just, she's like really happy, enthusiastic all the time. She's not, like, depressing or dramatic like a lot of RPG characters are. That battle took a full minute. Took a full minute! And I can't believe I was talking through that entire battle. Oh, we got a cutscene.
Finally. Halfway up.
If the air were a little more stable, I could get Baul down here.
Oh, look. She's awake.
My consciousness. This is what it means to become a spirit. Oh, to think of all the things that were hidden from me.
Guess she's awake.
So, would you still prefer to be called Chroma?
No, I am no longer the Entelechea known as Chroma. You should give me a new name.
Well, how about Sylph? It means the binder of winds.
Sylph. Very well, that shall be my name.
Okay, Sylph. Nice to meet you. Again.
A pleasure to meet you too.
Sylph, would you tell us why Duke hates humans?
Very well. You know about the Great War, right? There were Entelechea who chose to live with humans, and those who chose to oppose them. The Great War was between humans who broke an ancient prohibition and the Entelechea who opposed them.
And the war ended when the hero Duke won victory for the humans.
Duke's a hero?
Really?
That's one of the truths the Empire's hiding.
Humans alone could not have won that war. Lucifer, the leader of the Entelechea advocating living with humans, fought alongside them and granted them victory.
Are you serious? Even I never heard that. But what does this have to do with Duke not trusting humans?
Lucifer was Duke's friend. Duke fought with Lucifer against the leader of the ones who opposed humans and defeated him. However, once the war ended, the Empire feared Lucifer's power. They assaulted the injured Lucifer and took his life. He had promised Duke that he would merely watch, but it didn't matter.
No.
Now I get it. Anyone would stop trusting humans after that.
I had no idea that was going on during the war.
But it doesn't matter how badly he was betrayed. He has no right to sacrifice every human life.
If you do not destroy the Autophagos before Duke, in the end, humanity will be destroyed. Hurry. I have calmed the winds. I believe Baul can reach you now.
Thank you, Sylph.
So the spirits are working out all right, but...
Duke isn't.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're kind of running out of time. Why would you say no to this?
To get the four elemental spirits.
Yeah. Now.
We have to convert the world's Blastia cores to spirits.
Right.
If we could control the Autophagos with just those four, then we wouldn't need the others.
But...
That thing is not exactly something you want to take on lightly. We better make damn sure we're set. There's no second chance.
Raven, watch your language.
I know. Just by creating the spirits, we've already changed Terka Lumerae's, even if it is to save the world. We've been making these decisions all on our own. Now we're changing the lives of everyone in the world. That can't be just our decision.
Yeah, you're right.
If we can't get them to understand what we're trying to do, we're just as bad as Alexei. But we don't have time.
But we can still talk to the Imperial Knights and the Guilds, right?
But if they don't approve of how we're doing things, we will become the Great Evil.
This is not good.
I can't stand by and watch the world be destroyed. Even if Duke manages to save the world his way, it doesn't mean anything if there's no one left to live in it. So I don't care if people call me evil. I will give up the Blastia to defeat the Autophagos. What are you going to do? If you want to get off, now's the time.
I'm going. My life belongs to brave Vesperia anyway.
Me too. Pharaoh and Bellius left it to us, and I don't like leaving things half-finished.
I know what it feels like to regret what you didn't do. If I stop now, I'll really regret it.
Yeah, me too. I don't want to feel like that.
No matter what path I choose, I can take whatever happens. I've learned that on this journey.
And the people of the world will understand. They're strong enough to take a changing world.
Yeah. We do this today so we can laugh tomorrow. That's what I believe.
I don't know if we'll be laughing unless something really funny happens today, though. That doesn't really make any sense.
All right, everyone. Together until the end.
So let's get ready and then go talk to His Majesty Yoder and the people in the Union.
So what exactly do you need to get ready?
Leave it to me. I want to stop by a city somewhere. I need to pick up some stuff.
How about Port Nor? It's at the edge of Illichia.
I want to find out what's happened at Emmeep Hill since the road was blocked too.
Looks like we need to head to Emmeep Hill.
Undine, Efreet, Gnome, Sylph, the spirits of the four great elements have been born!
The Entelechea were thinking of the planet after all. I was worried there for a little bit, but that wasn't too bad.
Yuko surviving by the skin of our teeth, not too bad?
Ha-ow!
Anyway, we can defeat the Autophagos for sure now, right?
Not yet. There's still too many unknown variables. Hypothesize, test, evaluate, then prove. We have to follow the proper steps to ensure success. I'm not even sure how effective the four elements will be in converting air to mana yet. Wait, could the mana from the loss of materialized air created by the spirits be maintaining the balance? If so, then I shouldn't be measuring the actual value, but... No.
She's gone. Right.
I mean...
Okay, she's gone.
Yep, I'd say there's nothing to worry about.
What's with that little musical note there? I thought that meant, like, Estelle would, like, you know, have her happy face on or something, and what's going on?
Is Bile doing all right? Sure he's not getting too tired?
No, he's fine, but he's uneasy.
What's wrong?
The apatheia within him isn't enough to undergo spirit conversion yet, but he knows that someday he will need to give up his current form and become a spirit.
Well, humans are all going to die sometime, but we don't spend every day worrying about it.
I imagine some people do.
Are you saying Baul is that weak?
He's far more delicate than me, Yuri.
Dying, in his case, isn't exactly death like we normally think of it, though, right?
But it does mean that his consciousness will disappear and be replaced by something new.
So it's basically a fear of the unknown. That part of it is actually not too different from us.
The other Entelechea have accepted that they must become spirits. They feel it is their duty to maintain the stability of this planet.
Baul's got a mission of his own, though, doesn't he? I mean, what about his commitment to destroy all of the Hermes Blastia?
The determination necessary for destroying Blastia and becoming a spirit are very different. Baul still lacks the resolve to give up his identity as an Entelechea.
I think lacking it is a lot healthier, if you ask me. And I certainly understand.
He seems pleased that you understand him. Still, I worry about him going on like this.
Do you want him to become a spirit, Judy?
No, not in the least. But I wonder what the Entelechea, what the spirits themselves must think.
I'm not even really sure if this is even relevant to the plot or whatever.
I'm not sure, Baul and the spirits are communicating, or something like that, but without using their voices. Yes.
What happened?
He says we shouldn't worry about him.
But what was all that?
The spirit said something to calm him down.
Maybe they told him how easy they've got it.
Yeah, probably. At any rate, it's impossible for him to become a spirit now.
We're going to have to go on depending on you until the journey's over, Baul.
He wants you to know you can count on him.
Well, isn't that nice of him? Okay, we actually need to go to Miorzo for two really important arts. Technically, we're not going to get them there, but we're actually going to, start the side quest to get them. I'm actually going to avoid that con right there because I don't want to run into a certain cutscene. So anyway, here is Miorzo again. Let's go. So there's actually two cutscenes. I'm not even really sure if I've seen them yet. We probably can't get one of them, but there is another one that we can get. I don't know. I'll explain all this. So don't worry. You actually have to go into the Elder's residence and talk to him. And there should be two separate scenes here. So word is that you've been going around doing something or another to the world to send to Lakea. You made it sound so bad. We've been getting into Lakea changed into a different form, called Elemental Spirits. This lets us borrow their power, which will help us break up the Autophagos. Oh ho, I see. It is as I thought. Indeed, I suspected that you would be working to defeat the Autophagos. Again with the impressive calms. Am I correct? I am correct, am I not? Perhaps it would interest you to know that our people have been considering going down to the surface. Going down to the surface? The time may come soon for... I don't know how you pronounce that. Is it Crones? The Entelike, who carries Miorzo through the air to turn into an elemental spirit and help your cause. Do you think that likely? I'll admit it's certainly possible. The less patient among us have already gone down to the surface. Where do they go? I do not know, though I would imagine they'd be hard to miss. I wonder where they went. You can already find Gritians in just about any city in the world. Gritians can live anywhere, they're very practical people. Just like humans, I guess. I don't know why that was important. So anyway, okay, so there should be another one. But, do you say anything important? Maybe you can't get this particular one just now, or maybe you have to leave and come back. I don't know. Okay, so I guess. Anyway, it's actually a really good art for Estelle, but the scene that we just saw gives one for Judith. Now, there's also another thing that we can do here. If you talk to this kid, he'll actually have you play a game with Baul to fly through rings in the sky, and I believe after you do that, you get a title, which is important to get another title for Judith, which gives her a costume. But for the life of me, I have never gotten that one before, because you have to get, 1,000 fail strikes in total, and over 100 blue ones specifically, and that sucks. But I'm pretty sure it's not Judith who has to get them all. It might be everybody, but like I said, I'm not really sure how it all works. Oh, I occasionally just look at the guide and see. But yeah, so anyway, we can probably get the rest of the fell arms right now. How many do we actually have? I'm pretty sure Yuri is the only one who actually has them. Yeah. Which is, its attack is not very good. But for the life of me, I cannot figure out how they actually work. I heard they can increase their attack, but you have to, like, kill monsters with them or something like that. I don't know. It's very, very unusual. Have I defeated the Jacanto monster here? So anyway, the Critians that were mentioned earlier are actually at Mount Temza, and yeah, that's the Jacanto monster, and I don't think we're ready to fight that guy yet, because that guy is freaking hard. Oh my god. You know what? I don't really feel like doing this right now. I'm gonna go here later. Let's just move on. But anyway, remember the ruins of the Critian city on Mount Temza? That's where the other Critians are, and they'll actually teach Judith a really powerful strike art. I think it's called Sundering Moon, but I can't really remember the exact name. But basically, it's she just whacks a monster with her staff really, really hard. So anyway, let's go to Nor Harbor, and actually, wait, there's one more thing I really want to check. Remember that art for Rita that I kept checking that you have to go to Ospio to get? I think now is the time where you can actually do that. But like I said, I never gotten this art at Ospio before. So I really want to know when you can actually do this. I can't really imagine it would be any other time. We have a cutscene. Do you mind if I step away for a bit? I'd like to talk to the mages here about spirit conversion. Sure, go ahead. All their blasted research might be useful. Useless pretty soon anyway. Alright, I'll try not to be too long. Ah, damn it. Why'd you have to go and leave? I'm pretty sure you can't leave the city without her, though, so I'm pretty sure we just have to go and find her. This might actually be when you can... Yeah, this is it! So that's about the long and the short of it. Wow, things have gotten pretty bad. Spirits, huh? So you're saying you want to take our Blastia research away from us? People can't live without Blastia. I don't like this idea one bit. You all sure talk big for a bunch of amateurs with underfunded research that no one cares about. What did you say? You want to rumble? I didn't come here to listen to you have your petty arguments. Can you just put your emotions on hold for a few minutes? Anyway, it says I told you, we mages will soon be unable to simply continue with our studies of Blastia. I just thought it would be best if I let you know. We can't accept what you've told us. Well, fine then. Even if you're the best brain in Ospio, you're still a child. Adults are reluctant to pay heed to the words of the young as you. Surely, that's all it is. That's really not the issue here. Adults have their own way of discussing things. You just leave everything to us. Right, we'll do something about that stubborn bunch. Sorry about that. Come on, let's go. Is it really okay to leave so soon? I mean, it's fine, let's go. I'm pretty sure there was something else we could do here. Because like I said, I've only gotten that art in Allure. But it says you can get it in Ospio too. But I'm just not entirely sure when you can actually do that. Maybe it's in Rita's house. I don't even know why I'm checking. That's gotta be uncomfortable in that dress. Anyway, nothing here. Look at all these, look at all these like beakers and test tubes and chemicals and stuff. It's like, geez, what exactly was Rita doing before we actually showed up? It seems she studied a lot about air, though. I'm pretty sure this is pointless too, but I'm just gonna go and check. Actually, no, wait. I don't think you can ever actually go into this little house up here. I've never gone up here before. Like, I've gone up here, but I've never gone into that house. Kiwan's in unique shape. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you can never actually go in there. Just, the layout of this, like, the looks of this place is actually really strange. Because it's actually similar to another place that we go to, but it's actually explained really well, but... doesn't look like anything... Okay, what? Excuse me. Oh no, excuse me. Here, you dropped this book. Oh yes, thank you very much. Collector's book, eh? Your contents are... Yeah, yours contains an impressive amount of data. Seems you found a lot of rare items. This is quite intriguing. Oh, it is? Rita's always saying now how we haven't found nearly enough. if it wouldn't be too much trouble. Yes? Do you think I might be able to borrow this book for a short while? If I had 1 month, no, even 2 weeks, that would be enough. Please, please let me borrow it. Ah, well... No, you can't. That's too long anyway. Mordio, you know this young lady? Yeah, I know you don't want to hear this, but we can't give you the book yet. Why? We still haven't completed it yet. If you'd look at it, you wouldn't a complete book be better anyway? We wouldn't have to lend it to you every time we make an update either. I see, yes. Then once you finish filling that book, allow me to borrow it for a bit. Of course, I don't expect you to lend me it for nothing. Of course, you don't have to give us anything, really. It's quite alright. We'll bring it to you once we finish updating it. Thank you. My name is Giovanni. Oh, come on. Please. I've had too much Pokemon in my life right now. Did you really have to throw that in there? You probably already know this, but I'm a researcher here. Okay, Mr. Giovanni, stop saying that name. We'll bring you as a collector's book as soon as it's complete. Oh, thank you so much. I'm looking forward to it. I have never seen that scene before, and I'm pretty sure it's not even really important. But that guy has a name, so he's probably important. Seems a lot of people have a high respect for Rita in this place, though. Kind of strange that she would be the smartest person, even though she's only 15. You'd think someone with a high school education would be able to... Nah, who cares? They probably don't have school in this place anyway. So anyway, over to Emmett Hill. I could have just walked easily, but I didn't really feel like it. Oh wait, that's the Koi Woods. Oops. Sorry, all trees and forests is looking at me. Excuse me. Can we just pass through this time? Duh. Is there nothing here? Yuri, why did you want to come here? This is pointless. We're going to fly over it. Because I'm not walking all the way around. Again, that's just balls. That's balling right there. Let's try going on the other end. See if anything happens. Oh, excuse me. Is there ever a point in this game where you can actually just pass through Emmett Hill? Just walk? Because I've never seen anybody do that. And I've never been able to do it. It's weird. So anyway, hang on a second. Do I have a certain title for Rita? I might. Yeah, I do. I wanted to make sure I had that new Dice Master. Even though it's not really important. It does nothing. I sometimes hate it when they give you titles that do absolutely nothing. It's pointless. And I mean, they're hard to figure out anyway, so it's seriously, what's the point? There's actually a title that we can get for Yuri, but I haven't really gotten around to it. And it's not even really important. It doesn't give him a costume. It actually leads up to a side quest that I missed anyway. So what are we doing here again?